lot of land doesn't need a lot of maintenance. So once we invest in installing the antennas, we can only need the bracelets, and the tags that are pretty cheap now. Now FID is still, the cost for FID is still going down. So it's a pretty cheap solution with a one-time investment, and the operational cost will be very low. Going to PLE, for example, I think you will have to have a lot of software maintenance.
This bands are necessary available for everyone to use, and there are definitely more people trying to use this bands and different other applications. How would you avoid that kind of confusion for the user, or the user being frustrated holding a lot of this bands at the same time?
Okay, this will also solve that solution, because this will identify you as an official pilgrim. So another problem that happens in the pilgrimage is illegal pilgrims. So if you don't have a wristband, it is a sign that you could be an illegal pilgrim. So that's why we use these bands. They're pretty cheap because we use RFID. It's pretty cheap to make, and they can be water resistant. So if people do the ablution of the pilgrim, it's no issue at all. And these bands will be given to all pilgrims because of their low cost. And this way, we also have exact location. If we go based on GPS or apps, we're going on the good way of the pilgrims. But I don't want my battery in the middle of the Hajj for 3 days, 4 days to put on my GPS. So this is actually the reason why we went for the wristbands. And as I said, RFID is pretty cheap. And you can make these RFIDs for a couple of dollars. But if the amount that is used in the Hajj, it could be even less.
It seems like a good solution. It's a cheap method of tracking people. I think actually there are ways you could actually have a smartphone that have the Bluetooth application. But one question I have for you is this. You need a network to be able to track people's movements. So the bracelet is only one half of the solution. Tell me more about the network that has to be built for people to be able to check in on their bracelet.
So actually, we're not actively letting the pilgrims check in. We can have later commercial uses. We can have it for the transportation. We can have it for food. We can have a lot of the rooms, lockers, and so on and so on. But the point here is that we will have these ultra-high frequency antennas, so they are long range, and depending on the amount of antennas, that's what we're talking about. If it's a dense location, we'll use more antennas to pinpoint it easily. For the less dense locations, we will be using drones, and we actually have expert drones
out here. So you did the access. So yeah, with the drones we can mount an RFID reader for long range, and I was working also in the US. I have started in the US. I basically did the video capabilities. I basically developed machine vision, machine learning capabilities for our drones to basically detect moving target indicators on the ground, and also be able to analyze certain scenarios, even explosives. So I think that's the thing that we're talking about right now. So I get the first from you guys, we're going to invest in our software and optimize it, and then also we're going to integrate more solutions. It's not only the drone, it's not only the software, it's not only the tags itself. And that's an argument in reality glasses as well, that I'm going to use it to detect explosives and hatch.
And then I can have it driving all the way around.
Yes, sir. It has an all-only feature too.
الفريق الثاني يعرض مشروعه ليتفضل.